I'm Dantti, and in this tutorial we're gonna make some rain with grease pencil. This is quick and easy, so let's get to it. We're gonna open Blender to 2D animation. First, let's decide what frame rate we are gonna use. I made the intro using 12 frames per second, so let's do the same with this one. Now, we can go to Materials tab and delete all the materials. Let's create a new material. Let's call it Droplet. Stroke is fine. Let's change the color to white. Now you might notice we have a slight problem. Let's lower the background color so we can actually see something. Let's also enable 3D cursor at the overlays menu, so we can see if it moves by accident. Now we can start drawing. Change the stroke strength to 1. Pick the line tool and draw a vertical line. Hit enter to confirm. Now we can switch to sculpt mode. Let's choose the thickness tool. Let's change the strength to lower value and check the minus. We can enlarge the brush with F key, and let's decrease the thickness at both ends. Once we are happy, let's go to edit mode. Select all with A key and move the stroke to the center of the orange dot. That will be our origin. Now we can go to object mode. Move our droplet outside of frame. Let's add a new plane object with Shift A. We cannot see it yet, but let's rotate the view a little. Now this won't work, so let's scale it down. Type S, then Y, and 0.2, then S, X, and 5. Press numpad 0 to go back to camera mode, or at the menu with view, viewport, then camera. Let's grab our plane with G key and press Z and move it up on the Z axis so it isn't in the frame. Go to particle systems tab and add a new particle system. This workflow will change in the future to a node-based system, but I reckon the principles will be the same. At the bottom corner, let's change the frame count to something like 120 frames. At the particle settings, let's change the frame end to 120. With velocity tab, you can change how fast the droplets are coming. Let's change it to something like -1 m/s. Since we are doing 2D stuff, let's check the rotation and change the orientation axis to global Y. With the physics tab, let's lower the mass to something like 0.2. We are gonna render this as an object and select our stroke object. Let's increase the size a little bit. Now we can go to cache and bake the animation. Now you can play the animation or scrub the timeline forward to see how it looks. If your droplets are too small or big, you can tweak the size at the render tab. You can also add some scale randomness. If your animation feels too slow or fast, you can tweak the velocity or change gravity at field weights. Just remember to delete and rebake it again. If you want your rain animation to start before frame 1, change the frame start to something like -50. You can also increase the number of particles as well. To make the droplets more invisible, select the stroke, go to Materials tab, click the white color and lower the alpha value. Now if you want to make more stylized droplets, go to frame 1 and go to draw mode. Select the erase tool and change the mode to stroke. Now you can delete the stroke. Change the droplet material to fill and add a nice blue color or something and draw a new droplet. Good thing with grease pencil is that we can change everything afterwards. You can also add effects to your stroke, like shadows or pixelate. But be aware, it will slow your computer down a lot, so use it at your own risk. Hope you learned something, thanks for watching and see you next time!